Just experience That's the Way of the World by Najee. His sound is sweet and mellow, and he has a new album out called Day by Day. We are very delighted to have him in the studio with us today. How you doing, Najee?
Good. It's nice to be here.
I'm really thankful and appreciate your breaking up your vacation time.
Well, there's no real vacation, actually.
Oh, no?
No, not at all.
You've produced two successful albums, Najee's Theme and Day by Day. What's involved in producing your own work?
Well, a lot of time, a lot of hard work, a lot of thought and thinking, trying to project what people will like, what they won't like. For an instrumentalist, it tends to be a little difficult because we want to reach a wide audience, so we try to appeal to many ears besides just a jazz listening ear. We want to appeal to the record buying public, so a lot of thought and time and planning goes into it.
Now, I, you know, the music world always classifies music, and every musician I've ever met hates classifications.
Sure,
right?
Yeah.
But, you know, that's the way of the world, right? So, how would, what category would your music fall into?
Well, if I had to give it a title, I think I would have to give it a title that relates to my personal experience as a musician. Mm. I've been fortunate to play jazz, traditional jazz, as well as Latin music. Mm-hmm. And I grew up heavily in the R&B field. I made most of my money in R&B. Uh-huh. So I think all of my experience is a combination of all of that. Mm. And I would have to say perhaps R&B jazz or jazz R&B. Mm. They have a term now called jazz contemporary, which I think is kind of safe for artists such as myself, a term that's safe because it doesn't put it in a traditional jazz category. But
what would you say characterizes your sound?
I think personal identity. It's just like speaking. Everyone may speak the same language, but they have a different way of saying something.
Yeah.
Yes.
You know, over the years, you see musicians who be 1 minute, and the next minute you don't know where they are. They make a lot of money, and then they disappear. And they wind up destitute, you know? I mean, you see old guys who have no money, and they're just barely living, you know?
Sure.
How do you approach the business side of music?
Well, I try to be smart about what I do. I try not to overextend myself into areas I'm not ready for.
Yeah.
It's very easy in the business that I'm in to get caught up in the fast life of overspending and, you know, glitter.
Yeah.
But I think I've been prepared well before this point to watch what I'm doing and to plan for the future.
Who prepared you?
Well, I would have to say my mother, for one, my family. Watching other artists, the experience of watching others come and go, as you say. And then fortunately, I've been around people that were wise and gave me advice and allowed me to watch their situation.
You know, you've been on the road with some real exciting people, like Chaka Khan was one of the first people you were out with. You just did a tour with the fine guitarist, South African guitarist, Jonathan Butler.
Yes.
And Angela Bofill, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Now, you know, us laymen, we're not musicians. It just sounds exciting to be on the road, you know, with stars and everything. What's it like?
Well,
What do you do when you're out there?
It's a lot of fun. However, it is a lot of work. It is serious business. It's not all fun and games, where it's really work. The people come at the end of the evening to see us and enjoy themselves. Mm-hmm. However, what it takes to get to that point is a lot of preparation, a lot of serious work, and, you know, but ultimately it's what I love to do. So I enjoy it very much.
You won a Grammy nomination for Najee Singh. Has that helped you at all? In which way has it advanced your career, if it did?
I think the recognition that I'm a legitimate artist in the industry was one thing where it helped. To be recognized at a Grammy on your first debut album said a lot, especially for an instrumentalist. Instrumentalists, again, have a tougher time breaking into those realms, especially on a debut album. If I had been there a few years, with several albums under my own name, it might have been a little different, but for the first album, it said a lot.
You're a single man, you're a bachelor.
I
mean, there's something about the charisma of a musician on stage, you know? I mean, the ladies like that, you know? You're handsome, you're talented.
Oh, you're kind.
So what's it like? I mean, how are the ladies treating you? that make you laugh.
Well, of course, in this business, you meet a lot of women and men, you know? People. But women, I tend to find they're very nice to me.
Okay, I'll get you out of that one.
Yeah.
If you had to say, you know, I think about John Coltrane.
Mm-hmm.
These are my favorite things. What would be your most favorite thing you like to do?
As a player? Or?
As a human being.
Yeah. Well, I think there's a lot I would like to do. I don't like to limit myself to just being a player, saxophone player. I think as time goes on, I would like to extend myself into production, perhaps even start a small label one day as an outlet for other instrumentalists. Most instrumentalists spend a lot of years studying their craft, and I think it's a terrible thing when you don't have an outlet for that. And it's nice to see that the climate has changed a little, where we can be heard again. I think I would like to make a contribution that somewhere down the line of time, perhaps starting a label.
Well, I know you've only been out there, you know, comparatively speaking to other musicians who've been out for a long time, but what have you learned that could be helpful to other artists?
I think patience is one important factor. Even though I'm new on the scene under my solo name, I've been out here 15 years working with different people for many years, so I didn't just pop up. And I think one of the keys to ever attaining what you desire is having patience and being consistent and working hard. And always keeping a good track record is important too, trying to be fair with people, not try to be, you know, sly, get things on the sly, try to be straight, you know, as much as you can.
Wow, well, you said your soul name, and Najee is a beautiful name.
Mm-hmm.
So we are so happy that you came to spend some time with us. And when you have some new music, let us know about it.
Sure.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Najee, extraordinary in his music. We'll be right back.